Good afternoon, slimy furtlers, or should I say g'day cobbers, because today I'm going to have a look at this video which was posted to the official YouTube channel for the soap opera Neighbours. I wasn't aware that they still made Neighbours. The last time I watched it, Harold Bishop was still in it and it was still on BBC One. But it's moved to Channel 5 since then, and I, Channel 5 is well known for its quality programming content, so it's a bad sign right there. So yep, so one of the stars, I have no idea who she is, she's very pretty but I have no idea who she is, has decided to sit down and make a little video where she discusses that video games are sexist. So let's see what sort of stuff she comes up with. Hopefully it'll be a good argument.
I've always known who I was and what I was about, you know, my likes and my hates. But just how much of that is real and how much of that is what we've been taught to think.
I'm very glad that she knows who she is and what she's about, because if she didn't, she would be suffering from a mental condition known as dissociative identity disorder, or some kind of schizophrenia, as it used to be called. So that's good, but then she wonders how much of it is stuff that she's thought of and how much of it that she's been taught to think. This all comes down to the realms of personal choice. Everyone is free to make decisions about what they like or they don't like. So, you know, the whole thing that she's trying to bring up here is completely irrelevant and doesn't seem to be covering the topic of are video games sexist. So, you know, I wonder what sort of tangent she's going off on here.
Like, let me ask you, why is it normal for boys to like blue and think it's okay to spread themselves across a train seat? And why is it normal for girls to like pink and to be emotional and sensitive? Like, who made up these rules?
Okay, I'm going to answer the questions one at a time here that she's made. The blue for boys, pink for girls thing is a genuine example of a social construct. It sort of came in sometime around about the end of the 19th, beginning of the 20th century, as some sort of marketing ploy by a department store, and it's just something that stuck. People are free to not put boys in blue and not put girls in pink if they want. It's all down to personal choice. So basically, by making that argument, what you're saying is people are incapable of choosing things for themselves. Even though it started off as a marketing ploy, it has become more of a tradition. Now, on the question of manspreading, not going to go into that because that's just a pathetic bedroom feminist fucking argument. And then to go on to say that who makes these rules? Well, nobody makes these rules at all. There is no rule saying you've got to dress boys in blue and girls in pink. There's no rule saying that men are allowed to, you know, spread their legs. Men spread their legs for comfort reasons. Like I say, I'm not going to go too deeply into the manspreading thing. But the one about why do women have to be so emotional? That's a biological thing. You don't get to decide that at all. Nature's decided that for you, or biology has decided that for you. Women do tend to be much more hormonal, and women do tend to be much more emotional as a result of it. Some people aren't, obviously. You know, there are some men who are emotional, there are some women who are not emotional, or just express emotion in different ways. There's no rule saying that everyone has to be like that. That's just an invention of, you know, this sort of modern bedroom stroke Tumblr stroke idiotic feminism. Sounds like she's actually just gone on, done a bit of research about feminism by reading on feminist frequency and then just not questioned anything it says and taken it as gospel.
We live in a patriarchal society.
Oh, for fuck's sakes. I knew that was coming. I should have known it was coming. I should have known. Oh, no, we don't. Why, yeah, this is definitely just a fucking, I read a few articles on feminist frequency and took them as gospel, fuck's sakes.
And it sucks. It sucks for everyone, but it especially sucks for women. We have to deal with pay gaps, tampon tax, breastfeeding.
No, there is no wage gap. That's been debunked so many times. It's unbelievable. There is an earnings gap, which is different from wages. Women all get paid the same as everybody else that works there in the same job. It's just that women make different life choices and so on and so forth. Tampon tax, or pink tax as it's sometimes called, has also been debunked because women's products that are aimed at women and that women buy of their own free will are completely different to the equivalent products that are aimed at men and that men buy of their own free will. If you don't like paying extra for female-oriented products, then just go and buy generic stuff. There's plenty of generic stuff out there that's often a lot cheaper. As for breastfeeding, I'm not quite sure what she's getting at, because she doesn't expand on the point. She just goes like, oh, breastfeeding. It's like, what? Does she want? Is she for breastfeeding? Is she against public breastfeeding? Does she not like the idea of breastfeeding? I don't know. She doesn't expand it. She just makes a statement and then quickly carries on. This is what happens to your brain when you just read stuff and don't, you know, apply a bit of criticism or a critical lens to it. Where you don't evaluate whether stuff, where when you just take things at face value, you end up spouting shit like this.
What's driving these ideas? It's the media. It's TV, it's magazines, it's fashion, it's video games. The media is making us look at gender in a way that can be dangerous.
Do you want to know what the definition of hypocrite is? Hypocrite is a young Australian woman getting paid a rather large amount of money to appear on a television soap opera, complaining about media spreading horrible messages. She also makes mention of video games for the first time, and we're now 47 seconds into her video, and this is the first time she's actually mentioned video games. She hasn't expanded on anything about them yet, so I don't know, but the media, apparently the media, is somehow, you know, responsible for everything. And she's quite happily going along with it because she works for Fremantle Media, which is one of the largest production companies in Australia, and has been since roughly the early 70s when it was called Reg Grundy Productions. So I love the irony how she dares to complain about it while she's quite happily accepting the media's dirty jewgold. And not only that, but she's putting this video on the webs on a form of media which is also perpetuating it, on the official YouTube channel of a program which is produced by a large media company. She doesn't see this, and this is one of the problems. People that just repeat crap like this have literally no self-awareness. Let's carry on.
For example, recently I've been researching video games, and in one of those games, a woman is kidnapped and she's thrown into a car. And the player actually receives points for doing this.
I'd just like to know what level of research is actually done on video games. Just saying I've been researching video games can mean anything. It can mean, you know, just looking at a video games magazine. It can mean actually playing games. It can mean watching people do playthroughs. It means it can, you know, watching people do reviews and criticisms of games. So she doesn't actually say what research she's done. Neither does she mention which game this is that she's, you know, that this thing there. I mean, for a start, it says, oh, you know, a woman is kidnapped and thrown into a car and players receive points. Well, I find that highly suspect, being as that most games these days don't work on points. She may be referring to like experience points or money generated in game, I don't know, because she doesn't specify which game it is. So immediately we've got off to a bad start there with a level of researchability and a credibility. You know, if you're gonna call something out, then at least say what it is you're calling out, and so that people can look and say, oh well, yeah, that's true, or oh no, it's not. Plus also, she's making out that in video games that women are always, you know, the victims of this. Well, no, it happens in video games. Men get kidnapped in video games too. And just as in real life, men, women, children, animals get kidnapped, you know, just grabbed off the street and thrown into cars. For example, there's quite a lucrative trade at the moment of people driving around and snatching people's dogs, you know, off the street, just bundle them into cars or vans so that they can then sell them on, you know, as some sort of rare breed or something like that. So unless you're going to be specific, your credibility points have just dropped way below zero.
So an ex-boyfriend once forced me into running away with him. He trapped me in his car and he wouldn't take no for an answer. You know, in his eyes, he owned me. To him, I was property. Like so many women are in these games.
Okay, so here we come to the emotional bit, which, oddly enough, earlier on she said about women being emotional and stuff like that, and then she goes and disproves her own statement by being emotional. However, just on first observation, she's got, you know, red eyes and stuff to make it look like she's been crying. But unfortunately, you can tell from looking that she hasn't actually been crying. She's just sort of rubbed her eyes to irritate them a bit to make it look like she's been crying. She is, after all, by profession, an actress. So, you know, she'll know all these little tricks and things like that. She goes on to tell a story about how an ex-boyfriend of hers once shoved her into a car and basically kidnapped her, wouldn't take no for an answer, etc., etc. Whether this story is true or not, I do not know. If it is, it's a horrible thing that happened. You know, nobody should have to put up with being kidnapped against their will, things like that, but that's the point of kidnapping. I do hope, though, that after the incident, or somehow she attempted to escape and then reported it to the police, and the twat that did it has been locked up, because that's what they deserve. They deserve to be locked up, because kidnapping people is a very serious crime. But this is the thing again, she doesn't provide any particular sources, so basically what she's doing at the moment is an assertion. It's a kind of listen and believe type affair. This is where you lose. If you just apply a little skepticism to claims and criticise them, you know, you can see whether they're true or not. If they're true, they stand up to the skepticism and criticism. If they're not true, then they kind of fall through. Unfortunately, at the moment, without evidence, then all we have here is just some sort of statement and assertion, which cannot be backed up, so it's not a credible item.
I don't know, I guess I'm trying to say we shouldn't be brainwashed by anyone, not by the media, by anyone. It's about personal identity. We need to question everything. We need to be critical, and we need to listen to each other.
Right, okay, so I'm still struggling to see how this issue relates to video games in any way other than the assertion that video games are sexist, which has already been disproven. Secondly, when she goes on to say this is a matter of personal identity, how does that relate to video games being sexist? Personal identity is your own personal thing, you know, might identify as a, you know, transsexual Chinese one-legged transvestite dwarf attack helicopter doesn't make video games sexist or not sexist, so we've got a non sequitur there. She goes on then to basically say that, you know, we should apply criticism to things, which she clearly hasn't done, so she's not capable of following her own diktats. And then she says we should listen to each other, so all it boils down to is basically I make an assertion, you must believe me. That's not being sceptical or critical of any kind, it's just yet another bedroom feminist assertion. In fact, she's less credible than your average bedroom feminist at this point, because, you know, she's tried to make out that she's a lot smarter than what she is. Either that, or this is one of the best trolling videos ever. But, you know, we'll wait and find out, because you never know, in a couple of weeks she could put a video up saying, haha, my last video was a complete fake and it fooled you all. Yeah.
I think we should be more than pre-programmed characters.
Well, yeah, so just to wrap up, she says that we should be more than pre-programmed characters. However, again, the irony escapes her that she is an actress in a soap opera. Basically, everything she says and does for a job is written by somebody else, and she just, you know, recites the words and does her own particular acting and stuff like that in it. Like I say, I've got absolutely no idea who this lady is at all. She's obviously a character in Neighbours, but as I said, I wasn't even aware they were still making it, to be fair. So yeah, just to wrap up here, all we've got is just a baseless bedroom feminist series of assertions, no evidence to back them up. She's making herself look ridiculous. However, if she could be very clever, and like I said, this could be a troll video, and she might do another video within the next couple of weeks or whatever, just saying, you know, I was having you on there, you know, just to get a reaction. And yeah, it's worked, but when you get celebrities and whatever like this, because I presume that there are young people and kids that watch Neighbours and identify with her particular character, whoever that character is, you know, they'll see their character saying these things and then pick them up and take them as gospel. Especially the very, you know, the younger people and you know, people who are quite easily led and gullible, who don't have the you know, sceptical facilities in their mind to just listen and look and take a look and, you know, decide for themselves whether what they're hearing is true or not. So yeah, thanks for watching this video. It's just hopefully, well, it won't be a quick one because it never is whenever I do a video. You can subscribe to me on Twitter. Well, subscribe to my videos. You can follow me on Twitter at the card that's up on the screen. And you can donate to me by PayPal. I really need the money at the moment. I'd like to buy a new camera and a microphone of some sort so I've got better audio. And there's a few life expenses I could do with some help with at the minute. So feel free to donate to my PayPal if you want, as little or as much as you like. Every penny helps. So thanks for watching, and you have a great day. That's when